Teofimo Lopez versus George Kambosos has kept so many people busy. An exciting fight with an unexpected result. Number one contender for upset of the year, maybe even fight of the year. In the Lopez versus Kambosos post-fight, we must conclude that the takeover who sat on top of the world from October 2020 wasn't the same guy who stepped into the ring with George Kambosos Jr. on November 27, 2021. And hey, it was a great win for ferocious Kambosos. However, merely based on the Kambosos fight, we can't say Teofimo Lopez has become an average fighter or a bad fighter overnight just yet. But since Teofimo Lopez will most likely move up in weight, the question then becomes, what is next for Teofimo Lopez? Hey, what's going on, ringsiders? This is your host, Boxing's Objective Observer, and welcome back to Ringside Stories. Feel free to subscribe, thumbs up, and hit that notification bell for the latest here on Ringside Stories. Thanks so much for your support in advance, and welcome to the channel. Teofimo Lopez's loss to George Kambosos Jr. will surely have made impact. Hopefully, the Kambosos fight has humbled and inspired Teofimo to come back stronger. At the end of the day, he's just a 24-year-young who has held three world titles at the same time. So depending on how much he grows from the Kambosos fight and makes the right decision in his career, he might be able to come back even stronger than before. However, Teofimo Lopez versus George Kambosos Jr. also proved that there are issues that need to be fixed before relaunching a potential new takeover. One, Teofimo Lopez has to improve technically and defensively. Two, Teofimo Sr. is not the right trainer. Three, Teofimo Lopez surely has outgrown the 135-pound division. Now let's assume Teofimo will have one fill-out fight at his newfound weight division of 140 pounds, and assuming he'll come through that fight, what will be next? Today we'll discuss three options for Teofimo Lopez at 140 pounds, so let's get into it. Number one, gervonta Tank Davis. Now, astute boxing fans will know that gervonta Tank Davis has fought nobody of note, at least as of lately, and the unwillingness of his promotional outfit is speaking volume.
What Tank has shown you, could some of the media have criticized him, say that he hadn't fought anybody. He putting asses in the seats.
Even though Tank Davis's promoter claims his fighter is a bigger star than his contemporaries, which he's proven to not be, there are plenty of fights at 135 pounds that Tank Davis should have, but till this day has not participated in. A fight against Vasyl Lomachenko.
I don't think about nothing. I don't think because all roads lead through Tank. Mm-hmm. Although Tank is the biggest star out of any of those guys. Any of them. They're not even on his level. Mm-hmm. None of them. Mm-hmm. None of them. Mm-hmm. At 30 or 35, none of them. Mm-hmm. They're not, I mean, look, can any of them sell any tickets?
A last minute replacement in Devin Haney.
Eddie Hearn a few weeks back mentioned to me that he was looking to throw Devin Haney's name into the mix for this fight. Can you confirm if a concrete offer was ever made?
And fuck Eddie Hearn. fuck Eddie Hearn. We're here to talk about Isak Cruz. We got a big pay-per-view fight on December the 5th.
And Teofimo Lopez.
He thinks beating Lomachenko made him an attraction, made him a star. And it don't work like that. This is why when some of the fans say, oh, well, you should fight Lopez or you should fight... Listen, how can you even entertain a conversation when these fucking clowns, and I'm talking about the dad, not the kid, when these clowns say he's the A-side to something? You're the what?
We know their argument would be we got the titles. We're the champ.
That means you bring the hardware. How do you turn that into revenue in this business?
Gervonta Tank Davis did share a ring with Teofimo Lopez during a sparring session years ago when they were still teenagers.
Yeah, I was sparring with him. He was a kid. Back then I even sparred somebody else before that. I was just working with him. He won, you know, this fight with Lomachenko, then he just say anything out of his mouth, you know. So I think it just, sometimes people get big-headed, you know, and they forget. But, I mean, he did what he had to do.
At this point in time, the likelihood of Teofimo Lopez taking on gervonta Tank Davis is slim to none, simply because the people behind Tank have a proven record of being unwilling to put their man in with the best, even though they wholeheartedly defend their position.
We want to turn this young man into a global superstar. Mm-hmm. And he's definitely on the right path. He continues to follow the lead and follow direction, and he's going to fight we're going to make the biggest fights out there possible. And with the biggest fights mean you got to fight the best fighters out there. And that's exactly what we're doing.
Which to me is a page straight out of the Mayweather blueprint. That said, Tank is an experienced fighter, having fought over 200 amateur fights. He has held titles in 3 different weight classes, although you can question the validity of Davis's WBA regular titles at lightweight and his current junior welterweight title. Yet for what it's worth, gervonta Tank Davis has a fan-friendly fighting style, and just like Teofimo Lopez, is vulnerable defensively. So if Lopez versus Tank would happen anytime soon, it most likely would be an exciting fight that could end well inside the distance. Number 2. Regis Prograis. Since his loss to Josh Taylor in the World Boxing Super Series final, which was a unification bout in the junior welterweight division back in 2019, Regis Prograis has won his 2 subsequent fights via TKO, recording 22 of his 26 wins by stoppage. With 2 fights in the last 2 years, it's a shame to see such a boxing talent be inactive. Regis Rougarou Prograis is an exciting southpaw who carries power in both hands, elusive in his footwork and upper body movement, which makes for a splendid fighter in the pocket with lightning fast combinations. His only loss was on the road against an elite level talent, which not only was a close decision defeat, but also a fight that rivaled Naoya Inoue versus Nonito Donaire for fight of the year in 2019. Teofimo Lopez and Regis Prograis have the making of a supreme stylistic matchup. A former unified world champion who has proven to be a formidable fighter in a division he stayed at for too long, who relies on explosivity from the outside yet can bang in the pocket and be a pressure fighter, against a former world champion who was close to a complete fighter, offering angles, speed, punching power, and accuracy to both body and head, who has a fan-friendly style and is willing to fight anybody. As of this recording, Regis Prograis is ranked number 3 with the WBC, number 5 with the IBF, number 6 with the WBA, and number 7 in the WBO rankings. Ring Magazine rates Prograis to be the best junior welterweight behind 140-pound king Josh Taylor.
I said, take a picture with the champ and the champ.
All right.
A win over Regis Prograis would definitely turn heads in the boxing world, definitely spice up Teofimo's record, and maybe relaunch the takeover. Number 3. Josh Taylor. 2021 was the year Josh Taylor proved he was the undisputed best in the 140-pound division, taking the undefeated records of his last 5 opponents, 3 of who were reigning world champions. The Tartan Tornado himself holds an undefeated record of 18 wins with 13 wins by way of stoppage.
What do you think about Josh Taylor and you?
I think it's a great fight. I think it's a fight that everybody wants to see. You know, they mentioned 2 guys for Josh Taylor, and my name was one of them. Some guys like Taylor, they feel like they've done everything in the sport, they have accomplished everything, and they're satisfied. So they feel like they don't need to fight any more top competition or anything like that.
He's a great fighter, I believe. I think he's a great fighter, great talent, but he's got some stuff to do at lightweight. But we'll just wait and see as it comes. We'll just wait and see what comes my way.
Like his predecessor Terence Crawford, who held all of the titles at junior welterweight in August of 2017, Josh Taylor is a switch hitter who is a superb boxer, crisp counterpuncher, and who is able to go into the trenches, as his fight with Regis Prograis showed. Josh Taylor is making his first defense of his undisputed junior welterweight crown against England's undefeated Jack Catterall in what will be a homecoming fight in February of 2022. So should Teofimo Lopez have a feel-out fight in his 140-pound debut and come through successfully, Josh Taylor versus Teofimo Lopez could be an intriguing matchup, as both guys can hype up a fight and will definitely not shy away from a war of words in the build-up.
Preference? For 140, Josh Taylor.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've been said that. You know what I'm saying? Like, but I see it, man. You guys don't see it, I guess, but I'm a fighter. A fighter recognizes a real fighter, right? Ain't none of these guys real fighters.
Yeah, I'm sick of it. Sick of talking about him, but he's a pain in the arse, that's for sure. He's a pain in the backside, but he's just trying to jump in fights, but you know, it is what it is. I'm sick of talking about the lad.
Yeah, I'm desperate to be great. I'm desperate to become a 2-time undisputed world champion in boxing history. I'm desperate to be a fucking legend. Yes, I am. I'm starving to become one. I'm starving to be one of the greats, a GOAT. So, yes, if you're getting annoyed of me, well, I'm sorry to say, but I'm not sorry. I'm going to keep calling you because everybody wants to see those fights happen. That's the thing, man. These people are like, oh, I'm tired of him and tired of this. But, shit, we make fights happen, man. I don't know about that side, but we're going to make those fights happen one way or another.
Let's hope Teofimo Lopez has learned his lesson in humility against George Kambosos Jr. Let's hope there will be not many distractions moving forward, which hopefully improves Teofimo's preparation. Let's hope Teofimo Lopez will get Joey Gamache again to lead his camp, or at least a better and capable trainer slash cornerman than Teofimo Sr., no disrespect, who is a dominant personality, yet technically and strategically has proven to not be a good guidance for Teofimo. Now, these are just my observations. Let us know yours in the comments below. Who would you like to see Teofimo Lopez fight next in 2022, or at least in the distant future? Drop your ideas in the comments below and let's have a conversation. If you're new to this channel, we cover boxing and combat sports through mini documentaries, backstories, and much more. So if you enjoy that type of content, feel free to subscribe, thumbs up, and hit that notification bell for the latest here on Ringside Stories. Thanks in advance and welcome to the channel. If you've done that already, you know you're awesome. We already know that you are the true undisputed world champion. Till next time, ringsiders, this is your host, Boxing's Objective Observer, the Ringside Stories. Thanks for watching and have a legendary day.